They're going to be 2.5 minutes each.
Props.
No, sir. I welcome the opportunity to contribute to this debate today, and I think it's timely coming in light of the government's decision was taken yesterday. Unfortunately, I think the decision that was taken yesterday is the wrong decision. I think it has been, outlined by other members here in the House, but I think, you know, when you look at our history of privatisation in this state, and the disastrous decision has been said by other members around the privatisation of Aircom and what that has meant for broadband provision across the state, I think this will go down as being a very bad decision indeed. And Minister, you outlined the two concessions in an email yesterday to members outlining the government decision, and you talked about either stimulus model or the full concession model. And it was interesting that you said in both models that the private sector finances and designs and builds them. But actually, we finance it. It's not the private sector that finances either of them. And the difference is whether at the end of the period of the contract period, we actually as a state have an asset or not at the end of that. And under the decision that you have made, we have no asset at the end of this decision process. And that is what I think is what's wrong with this decision. Because what we should be doing and what this National Broadband Plan should do is provide a future-proofed infrastructure for the country and for the nation. But we are going to give that away, and we're going to pay the private sector to take it from us. And that's what was wrong with this decision. You talk about a notional benefit in your contribution today, about a notional benefit about the state owning the asset. But yet yesterday, in your communication to members, you said that you recognise the potential long-term value in the state in owning the network. So, I mean, which is it really like? I mean, is it a long-term value or is it a notional benefit? I believe it's a long-term value, and I believe that if we rolled out a proper fibre optic broadband solution to every house and the premises in the state, I believe it's a long-term value, and I believe that if we rolled out a proper fibre optic, we would have long-term value, and it would pay dividends far and beyond the cost
seconds.
That it would take over the period of the concession to pay that back to the state in terms of job creation, in terms of rural businesses being developed, in terms of returns back to the taxpayer. So I think it's a very short-term view that you've taken. I think it's a completely wrong view, and I think, unfortunately, it's part of the privatisation agenda that has been running through this government and previous governments, and we will live to regret that decision.
Margaret, Deputy Maureen O'Sullivan.
Made to talk.